Welcome back to another episode of Recycle Garbage Truck Simulator with me, BradM73. Let's see, it is the next day from our first episode, and I was wanting to look at something here to kind of show what we could, you know, how the garbage accumulates, I guess. And so I left, I think it was Terrace Lane, I left unpicked up from the previous day. So it is Friday. So what I'm going to actually do, since I've got all of my trucks here at the garage, is I'm going to skip one more day. And, okay, see now here we're up to 93%. So if we go to Sunday, bam, that's at 100%. And, most of our other routes should be pretty high as well. So we don't, it looks like we don't want to actually do pickups every day. So let's see what I'm going to do. Since Terrace Lane hasn't even gotten picked up yet, I'm going to go to my garage. I'm going to go to my other guy here and put him on Terrace Lane and have him autopilot that. Meanwhile, I am going to do, I think it's there's Queen Street. Narrow Street. I'm going to do this one. So it doesn't look like we actually need to pick up every single day, and we probably don't want to because we want to maximize the amount of money we get per route, I guess. Okay, so so we want to be on Narrow Street. So we'll go ahead and drive this. And we are going to want to make a left. I wish the camera... Oh, hello. There goes our other dump truck there. Still don't have enough money to buy, you know, a new dump truck, but... Go. You know, I gotta say, for this not being a driving simulator, the traffic AI in this game ain't bad. It ain't bad. Instead of making a right there, I'm gonna go this way. Man, I wish there was steering wheel support in this. I would totally use my my Logitech G27 on this. Congratulations! Oh, sweet! Oh my God! Oh God! I can't move. Congratulations! You are gonna die. All right. So what can I do? Ooh, now I can get plastic. Ooh, I can buy a landfill. Garbage crane truck. Okay, so now I think I can actually go and buy... Well, let's just look here. Yeah, I think I might be able to buy... I might be able to buy these dump spots here, so let's look. Well, I can buy them. There's nothing to stop me from buying them, but... See, I don't know really what the advantage is of buying that plastic thing. See, now I can get a big garbage truck, and... Okay, so... Wait, didn't that say? Oh, next level, level 3. So, okay, so I unlocked the big garbage truck. So I can't buy it unless I get a loan. So let's soldier on here. Looks like Terrace Lane has been picked up. So we just have to wait for him, for my other truck to get back to the depot. I don't really want to take a loan out yet because I don't like taking loans out. Is that a traffic cam or a speed camera there? What is that? That a birdhouse? What is that? Oh yeah, oh maybe it is. Not a birdhouse. Like a crosswalk camera thing. That's what I think it is. Come on, get over there. All right, come on. So I earned 150 for that. That's pretty good. Oh wait, dumpster's empty. All right, put that back. Oh, and I got a speeding ticket. Or no, I got a ticket for running a red light because I was trying to go around the map and look for my other truck before I started the episode, and I accidentally ran a red light. One of the things that's kind of bad about this game, and I'm not gonna say it's like super horrible by any stretch of the imagination. It's more of like one of those things that's just annoying. Is the fact that now you might notice I'm missing these other garbage cans, and I'm just gonna pick those up on the way back. The camera view isn't ideal. I mean, it's fine, I guess, but it's not, it's really not what it could be. All right, so let's send him over there. Hopefully, I'll get a message here pretty soon that my other truck has gone back to the depot. But I wish you kind of had a little bit more freedom with the camera than it just being like locked to the back of the truck. So I guess we're gonna get 150 bucks for each one of these, or 150 euros. Hey, baby, what you doing? Oh man, why is she walking funny? Oh man, she's not looking too clean. I mean, good. Wait, what? What? What happened to your neck? Oh, she's freaking me out. You. All right. I'd have picked some better female models. By saying that, like the lead programmer was like, I used my girlfriend as the main model. I'd be like, oh man, sorry about that. All right, go over and pick that one up. I should have pulled up here so we would have had a little bit less distance to cover. This guy's like, wait, tell your guy to bring the garbage over. I mean, when I've seen guys, pick up the garbage, I mean, they're out, running, they're trying to get their job done fast so they can go home. I don't know if they get paid by the hour or the route. It'd be better if they got paid by the route, I would think. Dumpster's empty. All right, so we already made some money back to pay for our speeding or our ticket of running red lightness. Right, let's go. Let's go. There is the biogas plant. I don't even know if we can drive in there to it. It'd be kind of cool if you could. All right, I'm gonna pull up here on the curb, since that's what I think a good dump truck driver would do. right. 150. Hey, up. I'm messing around with my boy. I still need to name him. I got a few name suggestions, I think. I'll have to go look at them. See if I can bring up my other computer and see. I know somebody said go and just name him Billy Bob, and because I had mentioned that before. I don't want to just name him Billy Bob. I don't know. It's like too generic for me or something. All right. Let's get that done. In the meantime, I've got a mouse in each hand. Hey, that one wasn't completely full. Or was it?
Or was it?
Alright, dumpster's empty. Take that back. I hate how they just keep changing YouTube. Why do they make it worse and not better? I don't get it. Alright, there we go. Wait, I can probably just go around the curb here. Because I think there is another... Ah! Get that one. Okay, bring that back. Let's see. Yeah, just looking at the other comments on the episode one of Garbage Trucks of Recycle Garbage Truck Simulator. Koivo says, when are you using a webcam? Not anytime soon is the answer. Yeah, I just don't have the right setup to do it, and so I have no plans in the short term or even probably before the end of the year to start doing that unless some miracle were to happen. It's not that I don't have all the camera equipment. I actually have some pretty nice camera equipment, but in order to kind of meld it all together on the same computer, it'd be very difficult for me to do right now. So I'm currently looking into building kind of like an ultimate gaming computer, and I'm not really sure if I can make, you know, how quickly I can make that happen. I was wanting to make it happen by the end of October, but I don't really think that's going to happen yet. The new Haswell E processors just came out. I would really love to get like a 6 or 8 core Haswell E, but they're like the 8 cores are like a grand. They're like $1,000. I was like, but you know, it would be pretty awesome. The only downside is I don't really have a super great video editor for the PC. I mean, I've got Premiere Pro, but it's a couple years old and it's pretty complicated to use, and I don't really need anything that complicated. So yeah, I don't know. I don't really know yet what I'm gonna do there. All right, jump him back on there. Let's see here. Gamerfly666 says you can name him Billy Bob Bratters. I'm not gonna name him my name. Let's see. Look at the, gotta look at the right screen here. Andy Madsen says, name him Sluppy Joe. So I will keep those, I'll keep those names in consideration, but, I would still like some more names. All right, come on. We only got one more to go. Did the other truck get back to the depot yet? Oh, crap. I guess it did. Let's see which route. Let's see. Fire Tower Road. Let's try. Let's see how full that one is. Or wait, where is it? Wait, where was the screen? Is it on the, no, it's on the overview. Oh, it's the route license. Okay, so at the Bell, Fire Tower Road. Okay, so I'm gonna have that guy do Fire Tower Road. Parked, and come on. Fire Tower Road, and I'm not gonna have him dump yet. I'm gonna just have him, before sending, you need to assign, oh. A dump target. I got a dump target. All right, autopilot. All right, so we'll send him, take that back. And actually, should I get him? No, I'm gonna have him come up into the cockpit or into the cab. It's not an airplane. What are you talking about, Brad? All right, so I am driving this guy. And which route do I want to use? Terrace Lane. I don't want. Let's do Queen Street, I guess. What? Do I not own Queen Street? Oh no, I don't own Queen Street. Duh. Wait, the scroll bar does not work too well. Okay, so we already got Narrow Street done. Route 16 is over on the other side. River Road. Where's River Road? Oh, it's kind of over there too. Foxhole. Oh, these are big ones anyway. Okay. Little Cove. I guess we'll do At the Bell. Where the heck is At the Bell? Oh, it's like this. Okay. Drive! Okay. So we got plenty of volume. There's 26%. And I don't know what these big bays are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's almost like where semis would come and, you know, park or something. Oh, crap. Oh, we're up to $11,900. That ain't bad. I just want to know what the other guy's secret is in completing these routes so darn fast. All right, so we need to get down here somehow. We're up here, I guess. I guess the best way to make a right and then make a left at the where it dead ends up here. Okay. I don't know what the speed limit is through here, so. Wait a second. Where? Oh, I thought I was on a different road. Okay, I want to make a left here. Good thing I noticed that, because I haven't been up here. I wonder what that big, huge building is. Anyway. All right, so now. Oh, God, that dude just ran a red light. Beep. Oh God, I don't know what happens if I have no idea what happens if you wreck into other vehicles. Oh, look at the pretty lake over there. I don't think I've been around in this part yet. Now, there's like your pretty standard German or European apartments there. See those all over the place. Come on, go, go. See, I don't even have a, there's no horn. Like, I just hit the H button and nothing happens. I'm gonna slow down just a little bit. I don't know what the speed limit is down through here, so I'm gonna kind of take it easy, I think. Whoa! Whew. Alright, so we will start picking up garbage. Go, go! Go, Jimmy! Go, Jim Bobby! I don't know what to name him! Back. There we go. I guess after I play this game for a while, I'll finally, you know, get down to like which routes, you know, get filled with, you know, with garbage more quickly, and we'll be able to kind of plan our days a little bit more accordingly, or appropriately, I guess, not accordingly. We'll be able to plan accordingly. Yeah. Hello. Alright, get off and pick up my garbage. Pick up my junk. Just don't touch my junk. Let's see. Another commenter, Joshua Korea. Not like the country. Maybe it's Korea. I'm probably butchering his name. I hope it's not Korea, because that would be like really bad. But anyway, Joshua says, Brad, love the video. Make more and more. 7 days to... 7 days to what? He didn't finish the sentence. Josh. Why you not finish sentence? I'm pretty sure you're referring to 7 days to die. Yeah, I am going to plan on continuing to do more of Garbage Truck Simulator, and 7 Days to Die. I am going to be doing more 7 Days to Die. They actually got version 9.3 out about 2 weeks ago. I haven't really read anything lately on their blog as far as you know, what updates they are planning. Let's see, how are we? Okay, so he's still on autopilot. But it hasn't really changed too much in like 9.3, just, you know, some bug fixes. There were some things added, but not really as much as I thought. I actually posted my tutorial, my forging tutorial. I got that posted today for everyone's enjoyment. Oh, come on. Go, go, go. Now, why is there a dumpster there and then another one right there? I don't get it. Come on, change. There we go. Wait a second. I think the game wants me to go this way. I think. I could be completely wrong. See, there's like routes on top of routes. It's like, why would you do that? Why would you do that? No. Ugh. Bring it back to the truck. Yeah, there you go. Oh yeah, put it in me. Wait. Okay, one of my vehicles returned to the garage. Let's see. Okay, at the bell, we got that one. And I think we're good to go. Oh wait, long road. I'll have the other dude do long road. Okay. Long road. Autopilot. Are you full? Empty? What? Dumpster is empty. Return it then. But what was I saying? Yeah, 7 Days to Die. I'm spending tons of time with that game. Really learning a lot. Really messing around, trying to mess around with farming. Farming in that game still kind of busted. It's not terrible, but yeah, it's got some issues. So I'm trying to figure that out. I'm sure that they're going to continue to streamline that. But the devs have been kind of quiet for the last 2 weeks, so hopefully they're not taking a two-week vacation. Because they had been updating their blog, like, almost, you know, every day or every other day. And then all of a sudden, like, I don't think it's been up. I didn't check today, but I checked yesterday, and it still hadn't been updated in, like, a week and a half. So a little bit concerned. So I don't know exactly. Maybe they're just, you know, hard at work, you know, fixing code. That's what I hope. There's not too many bugs in it, though. But like I said, it's a lot like Minecraft. I think it's better than Minecraft. It's got way, way more potential than Minecraft. People are like, hey, when's your next farming simulator? And I kind of don't know. I haven't had much of a desire to play Farming Simulator lately. I think it's just because 15 is coming out in a, you know, what, less than 6 weeks now? You know, unless it gets bumped or pushed or whatever, it's still slated for October 30th or, yeah, I think it's the 30th still. And, yeah, so I'm just kind of like, eh. I want to finish out the series, though, so I'm going to have to bang it out sooner or later. But I don't know. I might do another video later this week. I'm just kind of like, meh. All right, return the dumpster. And then we got four more, and we can head to the landfill, I guess. We could back up and head out to the landfill right now and just save the garbage for another day. Because you can do that. You can actually, you know, if you're in the main vehicle, you can just save the garbage till the next day. Which is kind of cool. It's just like real life. I always hit the red lights. Come on, there we go. Oh, this is like a weird one. We have to go like up there. All right, bring that one over. Come on, buddy. Oh. Oh man, we're almost to level 3. Look at that, 87%. Dumpster's empty. Man, can we make it to level 3? in this episode. I don't know. Come on back. Come on back. There you go. Here's what I'm going to do. This guy's like, what are you doing, Brad M73? And I'm like, I don't know. All right, get over there. Get that. Get this dumpster. Man, this would be like a really nice town to live in, I think. I wonder if this is modeled after any particular town in Europe. I think I might have asked that question in my first episode. Yes, $150. Ooh, we're up to 14 grand. That's pretty good. Dumpster's empty. Just like clicking on getting him back to the truck as soon as fastly possible. What the hell? As soon as possible. And then I think I'm gonna go get a pizza because I'm getting hungry. Come on, move. There we go. See, there should be like some reverse horn or something like that, I would think. Come on. Yeah, I'm just gonna do it like this. Yeah, trees don't look too terribly bad. This game has kind of grown on me. Like I said, when the day the game launched, it was completely broken, and I couldn't even run it. Well, here's what would happen. I could launch the game and it would launch in like this really low resolution mode, and when you went into the display property or the display settings and you clicked the little right arrow to increase your graphics options, you know, your graphics quality, the game would crash, which is awesome, let me tell you. No, it's actually not awesome at all. So anyway, the game would crash, and I eventually, after, you know, 15-20 minutes of trying to figure out what the problem was, I went in and instead of using the right arrow just to like max everything out, I decided to click each individual graphics property and max them out separately. And then I was able to do that. So I was able to get the game to launch in 1080p. And I'm like, thank God, okay, now maybe the graphics won't suck. But no. So started the game, the graphics were terrible. There was like no textures. Like there was no road textures. It was just gray. The grass was just like solid green. And I'm telling you, it looked like something from like the late 80s. And trust me, I was around then to know. So yeah, the graphics just looked awful. And so so I was like, okay, well, I'm going to try to play it for a while. We'll see what happens. So I was trying to play it. And the camera wouldn't move. You know, your camera wouldn't move. The WASD keys wouldn't move for driving. Oh, I can go. It's a green light, I guess. Did I just see some raindrops? I think I did. Raindrops are falling. Oh, look at the cloud out there. I love it when it's like this gray color and you can see like the tops of the clouds off in the distance like this. I love that. I love it. Where I live, we don't have any hills or mountains like this around here. It's generally kind of flat. We have more valleys than hills. But I love seeing that. So anyway, I couldn't play the game. You know, WASD didn't work. I couldn't drive. I couldn't change the camera. Couldn't do anything. So I posted some comments on Steam, like, what the heck's going on? Didn't hear anything on day one. Then I think the next day the devs did actually release. Oh gosh. Oh, you got to get up in the front, buddy. Yeah, the devs came out and they released like a statement saying, you know, users are experiencing certain problems. Nothing that, you know, none of the problems that I was having were even addressed, at least for like another day or two. And apparently it had something to do with files that weren't copied properly, and they had five or six different things to try. So I tried everything, and you know, of course nothing worked. And I was pretty, like I think I said this in the last episode, I was pretty vocal in my disgust of the game. And the fact that, you know, you couldn't do anything with it right out of the box. Get that out of there. Get that out of there. There we go. All right, close up my boot. All right, let's go. We have completed the next, I guess this is kind of the second day, which I think is a Sun. Yeah, it's a Sunday. And we'll head back. One of the kind of fun things you can do is, this is kind of cheaty, but I was messing around with it the other day. Yeah, there's absolutely no penalty for going off-road, so I kind of thought about exploring around and seeing if there were any Easter eggs. I was thinking about that the other day, like, you know, if are there any Easter eggs in, like, you know, people's backyards, you know, like a nude sunbather or something funny like that. I don't know if you'd see anything like that, but I kind of thought it was funny. And hey, being that it's the Germans, you know, you never say never when it comes to nude sunbathers. Let's get back on the road here. But yeah, you can drive around. I don't know if you can. I want to drive up on that big mountain. That would be awesome. Oh, come on. You need to have, like, C for cruise control. And I can't skip forward today because I have to have all my vehicles back at the depot. Oh man, that guy totally cut you off. Oh no, he didn't. And we're almost back to the depot though. I hate the steering on this game. It's way too sensitive. I had to try hooking up my G27 just to see what would happen, just for fun. Well, at least the speeding violations aren't like 300 euros or dollars, because that would really suck. Oh, come on. Ooh, I like that house right there. That's cool. So it looks like it's got a level there, and then like another room way up there. Okay, we are back. Ah, hello, what's going on here? There we go. Okay. All right. So it's going to be Monday. And what I'm going to do. All right. I'm just going to fast forward to Monday. We're going to look at the route licenses. And I'm going to pick. Let's see. Fire Tower Road is the highest. And actually, I'm going to just go ahead. We're going to buy that route. and by Queen Street and by Flower Street. And I think that's all the routes. No, it's not all the routes. Little Cove. Alright. So I will mess around with this. I think I'm going to mess around with these routes a little bit, and then in the next episode we'll kind of pick up from here and see, you know, kind of where we want to go route-wise, and hopefully it will not be raining tomorrow. I love how when you move the camera, I guess it's kind of moving with the camera. Okay, now it's coming straight down. So hopefully you're liking the series. We should hit level 3 tomorrow, and then we'll be able to kind of finally start buying some cooler equipment. We just need money, so I don't know, maybe I will take out a loan. I don't know, but come back in episode 3 to find out. Guys, I'm BradM73. This is Garbage... No, this is actually Recycle Garbage Truck Simulator. It's kind of weird how they decided that name, but whatevs. Recycle Garbage Truck Simulator. As always, don't forget to hit that like button. Please do that. It helps me out immensely, more than you know. You know, don't forget to share. Please comment. Let me know again if you know what you want me to name my worker. And subscribe if you haven't done so. We'll see you next time. Bye for now.